With the holidays, a lot of people could use a little extra cash.
One way to get it, sell your gold. Five on your sides, Monica the Liberty's here to help you make the most money possible.
Yeah, you know the thing is on TV and the paper ads for buying gold, they are everywhere. Yes, that's because the price just keeps climbing. But as we found, how much you get for your gold depends on where you sell. Sparkling or scratched and worn, 10, 14, or 18 carats, from jewelry stores to pawn shops.
Just for the gold coins, $31.67.
Hotels to home parties.
It's like Vegas in here. Like, oh, she just got $200.
There's gold to be sold and money to be made.
$228.
Is that good?
Yeah.
Yay.
That's good.
It has exploded.
Beverly Baskin heads the Better Business Bureau of Eastern North Carolina. She does not use the term exploded lightly. Consider this. Last year, 29 people inquired about gold buying companies. So far this year, inquiries have topped 1,450.
It's an opportunity for consumers. They may make some extra money if they have that kind of jewelry laying around that they're neither needing or wanting. But it's just our concern is that they don't get ripped off and that they get a fair price.
So how do you get a fair price? First, know what you have. 18-karat gold is worth more than 14 or 10-karat. Make sure the buyer separates the pieces based on carat and does not weigh them all together. But what our gold selling survey found most important is that you shop around. We took 5 gold pieces, a necklace, bracelet, and 3 rings, to 2 hotel gold buying events and a pawn shop. We also got prices from a jewelry store. The same company operated both hotel events, but at different locations. The bottom line, the highest paying gold buyer offered almost double what the lowest was willing to pay. Here's the breakdown. The most valuable piece was this 18-karat triple ring. One hotel buyer offered $110. The second, again from the same company, offered $39 more. At $170, the pawn shop payment was $60 more. But the jewelry store beat them all, offering more than twice as much as the lowest bid. With the 5 items combined, the lowest offer was $367. The highest, $695. $328 more, almost twice as much. And realizing you were paid too little after the fact doesn't do you any good.
Most of these places are no refunds, no exchanges, no returns. You accept that money and that is the contract. There is really no recourse.
So whether it still glitters, is broken, or just no longer wanted, to get the most green for your gold, get prices from several places. And another note, remove gems and diamonds from pieces before you sell. Most companies pay only for the gold. Also, be careful using services that buy gold through the mail. That can be risky. If you do send it, make sure that you insure the package for what that gold is worth. And with all the options really for local face-to-face sales, that might really be the best option to do. But shop around.
Good information, Monica.
Nice pin.
Thank you.
I'm getting it later.
Nice pin.
Thank you. Keep